This performance of Romeo and Juliet will reach a community of primary school, high school and different community groups across Australia, and the outreach is over 40,000 students, so we're so excited to be able to deliver that to that many people. I've had to reduce a three-act ballet into a 30-minute work, and that's been a challenge, trying to tell a story in such a short amount of time, but also on four dancers. The common threads are there, there's a masked ball, there's a duel and a fight, there's a death, and ultimately, love unites. When I was commissioned to do Romeo and Juliet, I was hugely inspired by Keith Herring's Love Heart print, Untitled, and this kind of sparked me to set the scene in pop art culture of the 1980s.
We talked about what 80s inspiration was, and pop art was the answer. So we looked at Warhol, Keith Haring. So if you look at the set design now, it's kind of taken and inspired by Keith Haring drawings. One of the main reasons why we thought about inflatables was just the ease of setup. So you pull it out of the suitcase, you plug it in, there's a motor and the fan goes. Reasons there is something large is so that the dancers can go behind, do costume changes, and also there would be prop storage behind there, so it's like all the backstage things.
So we have four dancers and nine different characters to tell the whole story. So we just needed really simple costume pieces that were interchangeable, and also that they could get changed just within the set. So really simple things to put on and off without a mirror, without anybody helping them change. So that really influenced the style of the costumes. Everything has visible zippers up and down the front, really robust so that in the quick changes nothing gets broken, and then just simple hats on and off.
I've tried to explore the common threads of traditional Shakespearean movement and fuse that with pop iconic culture. So it's neoclassical in its style and very much inspired by the music itself. In classical ballet we have many mime gestures, and I've tried to create a few motifs relatable to today that children are recognised with. For example, the love heart, forming little motifs between the characters which can help them understand through the storytelling, because we're not using words, we're using movement. The storytelling of Shakespeare's play resonates with so many dark themes that are relatable to society today. Amongst the world, and children study it within their curriculum. So they're issues that are faced and hopefully talked about and discussed leading into the future. I think there's a lot led to the imagination for the viewer, and I hope that they can be inspired to be future storytellers of dance, of art, of theatre in the future.